The RPI Pep Band. Please welcome the engineers. Once again, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Rensselaer and Houston Fieldhouse for tonight's ECAC matchup between the Crimson of Harvard University and your Engineers of Rensselaer. And now let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's contest. First, for the visitors from Harvard. At left wing is a freshman from West Orange, New Jersey, number 8, Alex Gaffney. At center, a junior from Chatham, New Jersey, number 17, John Farinacci. And at right wing, a sophomore from Chatham, New Jersey, number 18, Alex LaFerriere. On defense is a junior from Southborough, Massachusetts, number 3, Henry Thrun. And a freshman from Concord, Massachusetts, number 2, Ian Moore. And in the goal, a sophomore from Scituate, Massachusetts, number 35, Derek Malahi. The rest of the Harvard Crimson and their head coach, Ted Donato. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for the Engineers of RPI. At left wing is a senior from Espoo, Finland, number 11. Aroville Lepinen. At center, a senior from Great Falls, Virginia, number 19, Tor Linden. And at right wing is a senior from Bratislava, Slovakia, number 39, Jacob Laka. On defense for the Engineers, a senior from Bloomington, Minnesota, number 23, Jake Johnson. And a senior from Howell, New Jersey, number 28, Kyle Hallbauer. And in the goal, a graduate student from Victoria, British Columbia, number 1, Lyndon Marshall. The rest of the engineers, their head coach is Dave Smith. Assistant coaches, Chuck Weber and Matthias Lang. Now we ask that you please rise as we honor and respect our two great nations. First, the RPI Pep Band playing the National Anthem of Canada. We ask that you please remain standing and welcome Autumn Guffey, Brian Wang, Clara Cinderella, and Chevy Chen, the class of 2022 a cappella, as they sing the national anthem of the United States of America.
Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to the Houston Fieldhouse for the regular season finale of ECAC hockey play on the men's side. It's Perilous Garris here with Dan Frigin, bringing you RPI hockey against the Harvard Crimson here at the Houston Fieldhouse. And coach, last day of the regular year, both these teams are locked into their final standings positions. So really just trying to, you know, continue to play good hockey and give a couple guys a chance to play, maybe their last chance at the Houston Fieldhouse.
Yeah, and right now with RPI, hopefully they can close out the weekend with a sweep.
Right, they haven't done that in a while.
That's correct. After beating Dartmouth last night.
All right, 1-1. A lot of 1-1s on the season. This is a team in Harvard that RPI was able to beat, but they were minus all of their Olympians. And most are back, aside from John Farrell, who is out with an injury. So a little bit of a stiffer test here for the Engineers, although it will be Derek Mulahy in goal for the Crimson, making just his seventh start of the year. Lyndon Marshall between the pipes for RPI, the grad student from Victoria, BC. Good to see Lyndon in there here on senior night, as this is his 26th game of the year. He is just the eighth goalie in RPI history to play 75 games at the position. This is going to leave the zone. Ottaville Leppin, another one of those seniors, will send it back. He'll play it back to Marshall. And RPI will reset there. Engineers 15 wins on the year, 15-9-3. Harford also has 15 wins, but they have 10 fewer losses. 15-9-3.
I don't think they played as many games.
that's exactly right. That's easy math for me to do. 10 fewer. This is going to be icing here on RPI. 18:47 to go first period. RPI won the first meeting this year. In Cambridge, of course. That was on a Tuesday evening. 2-0. There's an empty net goal involved there. John Beaton scored the first one, and then it was Jacob Locke, the late empty net goal. It was a good faceoff here. Linesman ducking out of the way. That is Mark McGinnis. He and Stephen Drain manning the lines here. Referees are Kevin Graber and CJ Hannafin, who is an RPI grad, class of, I believe, 05. Coach would know better.
Yep. No, CJ's not out there.
Oh, he's not?
No, that's Knapp and Graber.
Huh. Well, I got updated referees, and I'm in here. Okay, we'll have to change that. Anyway, TJ Walsh with a shot and a save there.
I was going to say, CJ
Mulahy
put on a lot of weight.
we'll have to cut that out of the broadcast, Coach. 2 minutes gone, one shot on goal so far belongs to RPI. It was right there.
Sure, editing crew.
Yeah, they're right on that, I'm sure. That's their top priority. Kyle Hallbauer will dump in, and Engineers will change. Ian Moore, freshman from Concord, Massachusetts. Work it up the wall and fire it around. Tie up in the corner. Austin Wong is there, along with Tommy Lyons. And it'll be RPI to break it out. Jack Agnew, sophomore from Oakville, Ontario. Turned around in a hurry by Moore, and they're onside at the line as Wong dragged that toe. RJ Murphy, senior from Needham, working it back up the boards, and now it's sent backwards, hit the referee, Seller.
Oh, that stung a little bit for Mr. Graber.
Our officials are taking a punishment early on in this game. He had McInnes getting nicked on the faceoff, and then he had Kevin Graber getting hit by a puck there.
I'm sure he had a... and it wasn't watch where you're shooting.
Yeah. Seedham working it up the boards. This is going to be icing here as Anthony Baxter's the first one down the ice, the grad student. Former UMass Lowell Riverhawk will send the draw back down ice. 3.5 gone here in the opening period. And what are you trying to get out of games like this, Coach, that technically don't have any meaning? And, you know, Harvard was in the, you know, maybe trying to look for an at-large potential, but they lost to Union yesterday, and that kind of quelled that thought.
Yeah, I think right now they're just trying to play. Each team is trying to play to their identity.
Right. into the zone. Shot and a blocker save. That was LaFerriere. And now Lapinet dumps in. Moore. It's interesting, the Crimson have both Henry Thrun and Ian Moore, both Ducks draft picks, paired up together. Now a jam try at the net front as that puck just came loose for Karpa. But he was a little too close to Marshall there and put it off his pad. Good stick handling at center by Matthew Coronado. And now he'll dump into the corner. Jake Johnson, senior from Bloomington, Minnesota, ran into his parents downstairs before the game. Glad they're able to attend his final regular season home game as another shot comes in on Marshall there. Hallbauer feeds it down the middle. Tip pass for Walsh. Walsh flying in. Lost the handle, then he gets dumped over there. Good hit by Christian Jimenez, listed as the 7th D. And he's really throwing his body around as he runs into Adamo. Not a very big kid, but he's already thrown two hits today. Dug out of the corner by John Fusco. He'll go right back behind. Jimenez will ring it around. Hallbauer trying to keep the zone, and he could not. And Adamo has it back out to center ice. Dylan Davies, sophomore from Traverse City, Michigan. Getting another chance here. His 9th appearance, does have a couple assists on the air, and takes a quick change here. Moved up ice by the Crimson, 2-on-2. They elect to just dump in. Tommy Lyons there. Puts a hit on Louis Helson. It'll be shoveled out into Harvard territory. Helson, shot coming from Gagneau, and that's deflected up into the netting out of play. Jake scoring his first collegiate goal yesterday against the Big Green, and RPI's comeback win 6-3. RPI was able to get that victory.
Yeah, he had a good game yesterday.
Could have had a couple.
Yeah. Yep. You know you're doing something right when you're getting opportunities.
Harvard lost to Union 5-3 yesterday in Schenectady. They have to go and play again tomorrow at Princeton. That's a 4 o'clock puck drop. 3-3 is tough. Did you ever have to play 3-3?
No.
Other than the playoffs, no. I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
But not in the regular season.
Yeah, we did play one time in the playoffs. Actually, it was against Dartmouth. We beat Dartmouth. We lost to Dartmouth, and then we lost to Dartmouth at Dartmouth.
Okay. Lepinen got tripped up. Nothing coming here. He was dragged into the zone by Tour Linda, but he lost it. We gather up at center ice by Simon Chelberg. 21 points on the year for Chelberg. Tops him in RPI blue liners. And the lone NHL draft pick on the RPI roster. Harvard has a few more, as their line chart indicates, Coach.
Yes, I saw that.
You noticed. Yeah. Chelberger Rister looking for the back door. Maybe it was a pass for Baxter as it's flipped back out to center ice. Chelberg, the lone man back. He'll hand it off to Anthony Baxter. Pass broken up. Skated ahead. Farinacci sends it across. Shot wired high from LaFerriere. Rung back in by Rafai. Delayed offside here, but the puck comes out to center anyway. Nick Bowman, one of the RPI seniors, will dump in here. Nick playing in his 60th game for RPI in his career, 10 career points for him. He scored some real big goals in his career. There's a wraparound try, and Marshall keeps it out, and then he'll glove it. That was Karpa trying to wheel around the RPI net.
That almost took a bounce over the pad. Kind of elevated up in the air. But Marshall was able to grab it. You speak of draft choices out there right now, it's Coronado, and he happens to be the highest NHL draft in Harvard hockey history. He was picked 13th overall in the first round.
That's not bad. Calgary Flames. Moore makes a move. He'll take a shot. That's deflected. Good block by Walsh that time to steer that thing wide of the goal. Agnew lifting it along for Walsh. Touch pass for Adamo. Had to reach back for it. It slowed him up. He'll go cross ice for Johnson. Back for Beaton. Passes behind him. Chip back the other way. Into the zone, 2-on-1. Coronado walking in. Toe drag shot. He scores. What a move by Matthew Coronado, the freshman. Coach was just talking about him. That's his 13th goal of the year, and it's 1-0 Harvard.
Well, you see why he was a high draft pick. I mean, he just toe dragged that. And it's one thing to toe drag it, but look, watch the release on this. Zing, top shelf, over the glove of Marshall, who really didn't have a lot of chance on that one.
So Harvard scores on its fifth shot of the game.
Which, with the exception of last night's game at Union, they've scored first in 15 of their last 26 games. They've outscored their opponent 29-18 in the first period.
Harvard goal was scored
by number 19,
Matthew
Coronado. A help to play
from
ahead, of course. That's going to leave the ice.
He was assisted by number 59, Zachary Karpa. And by number 2, Ian Moore.
So it's Karpa and Moore on the assist.
Goal
Coronado
by
scoring
Coronado from
out of Greenlawn, New York.
And two more
played
with
Chicago
16.
Steel. And that's 13 goals and now 27 games for them. That's a pretty good rate if you're scoring half a goal a game, especially during your freshman season. This was a Harvard team that was scoring almost at will to start the year, remember. They had a couple of real big scoring outputs, and it's been a little bit tougher to come by as the season has gone along. But that's when you get closer to playoff hockey, Coach. It's tougher to score, seemingly.
Well, they're still scoring 3.2.
Oh, yeah. No,
I'm, game, yeah.
The average is still there, but yeah. They were the first couple of weekends, they were just going off on teams. Dartmouth suffered the brunt of that, I think, early.
Well, that's one thing as playoffs draw near, which we're a week away from.
Yeah.
Things, the space on the ice really becomes limited. Things tighten up defensively, so as the season has gone along, goals will be harder to come by.
Seemingly, although the Engineers had no problem yesterday against a very good goalie in Stevenson for Dartmouth. Clay Stevenson, who came in with real good numbers. They were hurt a little bit by RPI. Of course, the Engineers did have two empty netters.
Yeah.
In their 6-3 win. But, you know, this month they put up 6 against Dartmouth, 6 against Cornell. Of course, it wasn't Cornell's starting goalie at the time, but you can only play against who is out against there, right?
Yeah.
Who's on the other side of the ice? Seller.
I think they had a couple open net goals against Cornell, too, didn't they?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It was almost a kind of a mirror image type of game where they were down and came back. And
exactly.
The more that I think about it, I think it was almost exactly the same game. Except they were down 2-1 instead of 3-1. Here's a puck flipped on goal. And it's Malahi to cover out of Scituate, Massachusetts. Is Derek Malahi, a sophomore. 2.61 goals against, 8.95 save percentage. You'd like to get that number up.
RPI Athletics would like to remind everyone.
But the sample size isn't huge, so you can't really rely too much on the 6 games
you've
played so far.
We thank you for your cooperation.
Whereas at the other end, Lyndon Marshall's been very consistent to his career numbers, which are startlingly close to 3 goals against and a 900 save percentage. He's been that way just about his whole career. And certainly consistent in that form.
I was just going to say, that's the one thing you look for a goaltender, a good goaltender, is consistency.
Puck out to center. Chance for the Crimson. And they score again. Top corner, it's Thrun, the defenseman on the rush, with his 5th goal of the year after taking a nice feed from Laferriere, and it's 2-0.
Well, Thrun has 24 points on the season, tied with Laferriere, and he just went ahead. Laferriere is the leading scorer on the Harvard team as a defenseman.
Well, I think Laferriere is going to go with him with that pass.
That's true.
So, not to rain on your parade Coach.
But I didn't see who came to
play. It was Laferriere. Anyway, it's 2-0 Harvard.
Well, there you go. No wonder they're tied.
They keep giving it to each other. Well, you're right about that. Anyway, so 2-0 Harvard here.
Harvard goal scored by number 3,
Agnew.
Henry Thrun.
Johnson, and now
he was assisted by number
lifted
18,
in the air to center ice by Walsh. Knocked down by Beaton. Tries to make a move.
Time
but
that goal, 10 minutes, 13
overskated
seconds.
The puck.
Harvard goal.
So stay on the ice here. I thought it might have gone to the bench. Now it's stolen in the slot. Coronado trying to hand it off there for Donato. Or excuse me, Abbruzzese. Wearing Ryan Donato's number, and that's why I was confused. Back the other way. Centering pass. Nice defensive play by Agnew to get down and block that pass in a semi-two-on-one situation.
Yeah, Coronado was breaking to the net pretty hard.
And now Bowman. He'll skate it into the zone. Takes a hit. And he'll be sent rolling back down the other way. Davies, well, Ryan Donato is dating myself a little bit here. But it is Jack wearing number 10.
Yeah, he's had two sons playing for the team, huh?
Yeah. Ryan's, of course, now at the expansion Seattle Kraken. But Jack's a senior. Rolling puck into RPI territory. Chilbert. Seller. Good find. Dubinsky at center. A little bit of space. Hands it off there. Gagneau shot blocked away into the netting. And a faceoff will come up here in the Harvard zone.
Nice little play by Gagneau there to recognize the two-on-two and come over and cross with Dubinsky.
Shots are 6-2 Harvard. Attempts are 10-6.
Hey, if you can't make it to a home game,
face-offs
you can
are
still
even,
watch it live
or
on RPI
even, 6-4 Harvard.
All RPI men's and women's
early on in this one. Media stoppage here. They'll clear off some of the ice. RPI doesn't know who it's playing yet, Coach, but judging by how some of these games have gone for them, there seems like there's a few teams I kind of want to avoid, one of them being Yale.
Yeah.
Who they don't seem to be able to solve right now.
Yale's playing pretty well.
They just beat Clarkson. So aside from not matching up seemingly with the Bulldogs,
yeah,
seems like anybody else, you'd probably want to play anyone else seemingly right now.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I don't know if you can look at it that way. But
you can.
But you know what? There are teams, and it's obvious that you recognize throughout the season that you just don't match up well against.
Right. It's almost a few years running now with the Bulldogs, too,
yeah.
Which is why I say, you know, Yale beat the Engineers in the postseason a couple years ago, the year before the COVID year, where RPI was set to host Harvard here. I was just talking to Jeff Weinstein, who's the SID for Harvard. And the last text conversation we had, because we're obviously real busy, and was from March 11th, when we're talking about the fact that RPI and Harvard's series is about to be canceled. So if you remember back in 2020, RPI was supposed to host Harvard here in the playoffs. Harvard pulled out. They were the first team to pull out.
Yep.
So then RPI got Colgate for a day, maybe, or two.
Yep.
And then we're back to hockey here. We'll wrap this up. But then, of course, everything came down and halted hockey for over a year as that centering pass came through. It was funny. We were texting this week, and that was our last conversation we were talking about. What we were going to do and what this COVID thing was.
Well, I remember when Harvard pulled out, I called up Steve Hagwell and said, hey, what do you think? He goes, hey, this is a fluid situation. Who knows?
Yeah,
so
right.
We're going to go to now Colgate.
Yep.
Is going to be the next team.
Mm-hmm.
And then by the end of the week, it was done.
It was done.
Yep.
That was unfortunate, of course, because of the season RPI was having. And if there's any kind of, you know, maybe a little bit of retribution, RPI can go on a run here in the playoffs and maybe get some folks in the building next weekend, too. Adamo bouncing puck into the slot. It'll be played out to center ice. Beaton on it there. Sophomore from Stittsville, Ontario, has good hands, and he's able to work it ahead to Adamo.
With the backhand.
Watch out. Johnson, a shot that goes wide. Looking for the tip from Walsh. He nearly got it. And now Walsh at center, across for Beaton. This is better from the Engineers. Drop past Johnson. Takes a hit up high there. And it's tapped out to center ice, where LeFerrier had it for a moment. Now Bowman. Sparinacci was upended. Getting a little bit.
I think that was retribution for
the
hit.
I think it was. A little bit physical out there. to the line. Shelberg looked like he took his eye off it maybe there, and it hopped over his stick. Baxter for Mashey. Picked up an assist yesterday to Ryan Mashey in the 6-3 win. RPI had two power play goals against the Big Green. Abrazisi. Stick handling, sends it across. It'll be picked up there by Fusco. And now backing out to center is Kyle Acoin. Look how quickly Harvard turns things around. They shoot and score. Zachary Karpa, the freshman from Newport Beach, California, makes it 3-0, his sixth goal of the year.
Wow, and he goes high, too, with the snapshot over the glove hand of Marshall using Coronado as a decoy here. Everybody thinks he's going to make the pass, but he snaps that right off.
It looked as though Marshall was certainly a bracing for a shot there. I think the D had the pass pretty well covered, so that really that's all Marshall had to worry about. But another really good shot from one of the few non-drafted players on this Harvard team. Karpa, he's playing his 26th collegiate game.
It's his 10th point of the season.
Yep. 3-0 Crimson.
Pretty young squad as far as freshman and sophomore.
Right. I think that's what's led to some of their up and down results, right?
Inconsistencies, yes. Yeah, no
question. Very talented group, but
yep.
When you have youth, sometimes it doesn't show up, or you make some of those mistakes that are costly ones, and more veteran teams can take advantage of that. So
yeah.
It certainly will be interesting to see how the playoffs go for a team like Harvard. And really, Cornell is in a similar boat. They have some veterans, too, but a lot of young guys on that Cornell team.
And therein lies the challenge of coaching, where the players throughout the course of a season realize what it's going to take to be successful.
Harvard goal scored by number 59,
now
Zachary
to do
Karpa.
It consistently.
Assisted by number 16.
Puck played to center. Baker Shore takes a shot. Pad
and
save Marshall.
Number 33.
RPI
Kyle
trying to turn it around with some speed. They have numbers
that
they
goal,
hurry. Gagneau into the zone. Pulls up.
Seconds.
Sends it across. Slot shot. Save. Rebound loose.
Harvard
and
goal.
Let me send back the other way. That was Hallbauer joining the play.
16 Abrazisi and 33 O'Coin.
Good save by Malahi.
At 14-12.
Really much action.
That's the third RPI shot, but that one the most dangerous. As Kyle Hallbauer, the senior from Howell, New Jersey, joined the rush. And when you're that extra guy, you can sometimes get open like he did.
Especially in the slot area.
But good spacing, right, on that rush to allow Hallbauer to step in there?
Textbook. Real good execution.
Just got to miss the goalie on the back end. Helson going to pinch, take a shot. Bouncing puck behind the goal. Tour Linden's going to grab it there. 3 points yesterday for Tour. Now a shot. Agnew. Rebound deflects wide. Now Lapinen and Linden play catch. Otto Ville. Got to meet his dad and his brother yesterday.
Yeah, I don't know if Lapinen got a stick on that.
He might not have. Tough to see from here. Anyway, Agnew hands it off for Lapinen, who had a goal and two assists yesterday. Stretch pass is a good one for Laka. Laka shot, and he ripped it wide off the glass. Walsh, former Northeastern Husky, tip to the corner. Battle for the puck there. Good hit by Walsh. Beating the shot. Rebound pops in the air. And finally worked out by the Crimson. RPI trying to turn it around quickly. Adamo shoots it in. We'll say about Malahi so far, some of the few shots he's seen, he's coughed up some pretty big rebounds.
Yeah, he has.
They've been so big sometimes that they've steered away from danger. Now a backdoor feed. Puck still loose there, and another save by Marshall. That was Farinacci, who was in a little bit too close to the goalie there, and all he could do was kind of spin around and try to fire it on goal.
Good job there by Walsh defensively.
Alex Gaffney in the corner. Freshman from West Orange, New Jersey. Forced off the puck by Baxter. LeFerrier. Good poke there as Chelberg was shadowing him all the way through the zone. Thrun. Rister. That one goes wide. LeFerrier again. just dumping in as Hallbauer picks up. He'll try to clear. It's knocked out of the air. And a high stick, I guess, on Nick Abbruzzese, the junior, one of those who played in the Olympics for the United States from Slate Hill, New York. And captain of this Harvard team, along with Casey Dornbach. Fridge did my work for me. He pointed out there's only one Minnesotan. It is Casey Dornbach. Who is it? Former Edina Hornet. We've had our share of Edina grads here at RPI. Abbruzzese making a move. Sends it back to the point. It's out of the reach of Jimenez and out to center ice. Rafai. Jimenez. Yeah, two numbers in the 40s paired up on the blue line together. Don't see that too often. And now another two-on-one rush. A little give and go there between Carpa and Coronado. And that shot's going to be gloved by Marshall with a couple of players spilled outside the crease.
Just didn't look like Coronado or Carpa wanted to take that shot.
Yeah.
They were looking for the perfect shot.
Maybe one too many passes there. We've seen that. You can be too unselfish at times. We've seen Ottaviole do that at times as well.
Oh, yeah.
Last night he tried to make one too many passes. It turned out, obviously, not to matter too much as the engineers were able to hang six on the big green. Here's Shore. Baker Shore, junior from Englewood, Colorado. Behind the net for Dornbach. Back to the blue line. Nice move. And a shot goes wide. Penalty coming up here as Ryan Seedham walked his way in. And here comes the call. It's going to be a slash, says Ryan Knapp. And Harvard will go on the power play for the first time today. Wasn't completely obvious to me, but...
Yeah, I didn't catch it either. I thought it was going to be Laka. Maybe it was him after.
It was Davies.
Yeah.
Harvard's power play over 20%, 20.2, 21 goals and 104 chances.
Davies. He receives 2 minutes for slashing. Time of the penalty, 18 minutes, 41 seconds.
Abbruzzese, slap shot goes wide. That was Moore. And RPI is able to clear it out to center ice. RPI penalty kill. 87.2% on the year, 109 killed and 125 shorthanded opportunities. A Ferrier for Abbruzzese. Back up top for Moore. Abbruzzese, one timer, they score. It might have been tipped by Gaffney. The puck's definitely in the net. And it's a 4-0, a power play goal. They're going to give it to Abbruzzese, I think. Yeah, I'm not sure. It's going to be close whether or not Gaffney touched it.
It's going to be 16 from 18 and 2.
Look at you.
My call. I'm terrible with names.
Well, I can tell you, you got numbers right. 44 seconds left in the period.
As I said, they can really zing that puck around and open up that box.
Harvard goal.
For the one-timer.
If it's Abbruzzese, it is his sixth of the year.
He was assisted by number 18,
Alex Ferrier. So 17 of those coming in.
And by number 2, Ian Moore. Time of the power
Adamo
play goal, 19 minutes, 15 seconds. Harvard power play goal.
Rafai.
Scored by 16, Abbruzzese from 18, Ferrier. And two more at 19:50.
Nice job to keep the zone there by Adamo, but it pops back out. Beaton backhands it towards the net, but that's blocked. And with 2 seconds, Harvard trying to get one more shot off, and they won't. And that'll do it for the opening frame. Harvard taking the wind out of RPI's sails here a little bit. They score 4 times on 12 shots and lead 4-0 after 20 minutes of play. Coach, thoughts on this one? the good news for RPI is you can kind of throw it away at the end of the day anyway. You call it a meaningless game, but you'd like to see a little bit more, at least from them offensively.
Well, when they got down a couple of goals, you wanted to see a sense
saves
of urgency
in the first
come
period
into the
of play
game.
For Derek
now they're
going
to have to open it up
Harvard
a little bit, take some
Lyndon
chances,
Marshall
which is
going
to leave them defensively
period.
Liable. But they just need to create some more chances. I mean, four shots at the period. And let's face it, Harvard's got some offensive power, and they got guys that can capitalize.
Certainly
not
do.
Not that RPI doesn't.
Right.
They just
no,
haven't
just
been in situations. Well, they've gotten had a couple of opportunities where they just hit Malahi in the breadbasket.
A lot of hockey left for RPI to make a comeback in this one. We'll have the second period for you in just a bit. But until then, we'll take a break. You're watching RPI Hockey here on RPI TV and ESPN.
Ryan's Wake Pub in downtown Troy is proud to support RPI Athletics. Think of them before or after the game. Ryan's Wake, 403 River Street, downtown Troy. Boucher Financial Group has been serving their clients for over 27 years with offices in historic downtown Troy and Saratoga Springs. They currently manage over $400 million in assets and act as their client's personal CFO for any financial decisions. Visit boucherfinancial.com and learn more. RPI Hockey would like to thank the following sponsors: GE, Moe's, CEFQ, CDPHP, Boucher Ed Clark Financial Group, Yankee Trails, Nigro Companies, Red Front Pizza, Tri-City Rentals, Ben & Jerry's, Warren W. Fain, CDTA, Boucher and Clark Benefits, Jolene Morris of Howard Hanna Real Estate Services, Wicked Smart, BSN Sports, Tri-City Valley Cats, the Rensselaer Alumni Association, Patterson, Sampson, Ginsburg, and Griffin Law Firm, Rensselaer Dining Services, the Hilton Garden Inn, Troy, National Grid Foundation, the Desmond Hotel, Crown Plaza, the Recovery Sports Grill, E. Stewart Jones Hacker Murphy Law Firm, Stewart Shops, Stanley Steamer, Gatherers Granola, Rensselaer Honda, and Repeat Business Systems. They're all proud sponsors of RPI Hockey. Thank you.
right. Second period about to get underway. Engineers down by four. Here on the final game of the regular season. This will be shot down in an early icing call against the Engineers. 13 seconds in. Perilous Scares here with Dan Frisian. Coach, playoff hockey coming back to the Houston Fieldhouse next weekend. RPI doesn't know who they're playing yet, but has to be, you know, a fun thought that no matter what happens tonight, you get to play at home again, at least a guaranteed two more, and hopes of continuing on to play on the road the following weekend.
Yeah, I think it's relief psychologically for the seniors that, you know, this isn't going to be their last home weekend. And they can go out and play loose and, you know, do whatever it takes to get some goals back here. They're going to need to play with some urgency.
Here's Johnson. Coronado's wrapped up, as is Carpa. And now the Crimson moving out to neutral ice. Abrazisi flips it into the zone. Turned around by Baxter, indirect through the skates of Bowman. And they're going to call icing here. As I say, Nick didn't touch that thing.
And as tough as that score might look, 4-0.
Thinking about buying
one
or
shot
selling
at a time.
Contact Jolene Morris.
No, Harvard got more first, so
at Howard Hanna Real Estate Services at
518-331-1579. RPI is capable of
with
doing
the top sales team in Rensselaer County. Let Jolene's expertise move you.
Good connection to Dubinsky. He'll skate it out to center. Junior from Highland Park, Illinois, sends it rink wide to Schellberg, who just kind of wheeled around and shot it in. Baxter, the first one to the puck.
Good play by Coach Smith to leave Marshall in the pipes.
Oh, yeah. This will be covered up by Malahi.
If I'm not mistaken, wasn't it Watson who got the shutout against
he
Harvard?
He did, yes.
So if they meet up again with Harvard, Coach Smith will have a decision to make.
Certainly. Yeah, he's already in a little bit of a spot, right? Because Watson has been pulled from the last two games he started. Against Yale on Saturday and then last night. His numbers are still great.
Yeah.
He's 3 shutouts in 13 games. He had 3-5 at one point, though.
Yeah, I know.
But, you know, 2-2-3 goals against 9-2-7 save percentage. It's been a lot of, you know, great and then a couple of bad outings. We've just averaged out that way. We got a penalty coming up here on RPI.
Yeah, Dama's going to go to the box. Got a high hit there.
Yep. Second power play coming up for the Crimson. They are 1-for-1.
And if you thought they zinged it around at the end of that period with snowy ice.
Yeah.
Got a fresh surface of ice out there.
Rensselaer penalty to number 22, Justin Adamo. He receives 2 minutes for elbowing. Time of that penalty, 1 minute 58 seconds. 22 of RPI, Adamo for elbowing.
That puck shot out of play. We'll draw the face off up again. Slap shot blocked but not cleared. That was Seedham. Rister over the top that time from Thrun, who already has a goal today. Herman Carpa. Thrun. Dornbach. Gets it back. Sends it down low. Ferrier. Snapping it around into the middle. Finally stolen away and all that passing. And, well, that's shot into the bench. I was going to say, engineers just kind of letting the Crimson work it around the outside. And they finally try to get it into the dangerous area. And RPI was able to pick it off.
Well, I think after that first goal in the first period, they've tightened up that box and aren't chasing as much.
Yeah.
They're just being patient in their...
That's probably a smart move.
Yeah. They're being patient, not trying... Harvard's just trying to spread them out so that they open up the seam through the box.
Moved in by Abrazisi, who lost it there. One too many stick handles, and Chelberg clears it. Shots are 12 to 5, so no shots so far on this power play for the Crimson. No shots in the period at all. Abrazisi across, hits it back. It'll be gloved down, and a hand pass here as LaFerriere gloved it, and a teammate touched it. It's Gaffney, I think. Can't do that. Neutralized draw coming with 30 ticks to go on the second Harvard power play. Baxter just dumps Abrazisi, and he's going to draw a penalty.
It's nice to hear those chants again.
You missed him, huh?
Yeah. I'm sure the boys did, too.
Baxter's talking about his penalty to Adamo. He said, what are you in for? He said, probably just being too big, as usual.
Yeah.
Rensselaer penalty to number 5, Anthony Baxter. He receives
5-on-3 for 20 seconds here for Harvard.
Time of that penalty, 3 minutes, 36 seconds.
Right here.
5 for Rensselaer Baxter out of
Moore
trip.
Gets it back.
36.
LaFerriere. LaFerriere one-timer, save Marshall, rebound. Still loose. Back to the blue line. Moore a shot and that goes wide. One penalty's done. Spinorama and a shot there from Gaffney and deflects over the top. Now Linden hands it off and Lepinen will clear all the way down. Nice interception there by Lapinen. Oh, he lost the puck. Trying to fight to get it back. Regardless of how this game ends up, it's almost like in an exhibition type situation where you're some 5-on-3 time and maybe gain some confidence in that type of scenario.
Definitely.
And they're trying to kill off the rest of this second of back-to-back penalties, the tripping call on Baxter. Handed off by Coronado. Back up top, Seedham, Dornbach. Casey Dornbach spins it down low. Seedham, half fanned on the pass, but it still gets to Dornbach. Now taking his eye off, it was Thrun, and then he's tied up by Beaton. Hallbauer being patient in the corner, and it ends up working out for him. He finds Davies, but he can't clear it out of danger. Coronado, Dornbach, Davies got his stick in there to break it up. 13 to go on the Harvard power play.
RPI remains very, very poised in their box while complete control.
And a good save there, and they score with 2 seconds left on the power play. Coach was a little bit too quick with the praise as the Crimson make it 5-0. It's a power play goal for Henry Thrun, his second goal of the contest.
Well, what I was going to say is that they're real patient.
They were.
But if Harvard mishandles the puck or it comes loose, they really apply pressure. But in that situation, It was kind of a two-on-one on both sides of the ice.
Second power play goal. The goal came with, as I said, 2 seconds left in that power play. So Harvard Thrawn, who came in with four goals on the year in 27 Henry games, Thrawn. Has two in less
Assisted
than half a game here.
Assisted by number 59, Zachary Karpa.
Karpa
and by number 19, Matthew
took
Coronado.
That shot. It was a nice save by Marshall.
Time in the power play goal.
Karpa was in a real good scoring position in front of the net, but sometimes you're not rewarded for making a good save there, and Marshall wasn't as he made the stop, and it popped right to Thrawn, who shot it into a semi-open net.
That's Karpa's third point of the game. Goal, two assists.
Yeah, he came in with nine. He's pretty big for a 6'2", 190. Some guys just look bigger on their skates. Rafai's pass across out of the zone. Fusco sends it back ahead.
RPI's got to be, you know, real smart here not to play to the score and just play the game.
Right. And it, like I said earlier, it helps that this game has no meaning to the standings.
Exactly.
It's a lot easier to brush off. At least we can say that, right? I mean, of all the games in the season. It's, you know, if you're playing for an at-large position or something like that, it would have some say. You obviously don't want to lose 5-0 or whatever. But
oh, exactly.
You can certainly turn things around late and have a good feeling going into the postseason.
Well, I'm sure that Coach Donato was interested to see how his team would respond to the loss last night at Union College.
Well, he's seeing it.
Yeah.
Wong, touch pass here. Trying to give it back to him with Shore. And now Shore flutters one wide. Jimenez, a long shot, glove save. We got some contact away from the puck. Shane Seller is asking questions. I didn't see it. I was still following the play. Did you see what happened to the trailing there?
No, I think they just got hung up at the bench over there. And, Seller's going to get a penalty.
They're going to get both of them, I think.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Seller's pleading his case, but they're going to get Shore and Seller here. I think it's got to be two each here.
Yeah.
See if they're going to play fours here, I'm guessing, yeah.
I'm pretty sure they would.
Coincidental minor penalties.
Matching minor penalties.
Or matching minors, excuse me.
Assessed at
Roughing
7
call.
Minutes, 20 seconds to Harvard's number 23, Baker Shore. And to RPI's number 26, Shane Seller. Each receives 2 minutes for roughing.
So 4-on-4 for a full two. And it'll be skated out by Chelberg. Ryan Seedham, junior from Madison, New Jersey, will spin around in his own zone and then skate ahead. Seedham has it chopped away. Linden plays it backward. Now he'll get it back. A lot of space on the ice here. In most cases, you'd think would benefit the Crimson with all their skill, but RPI's top skill group is out there now. Try and match that. Here's Adamo. Backhand shot in the glove, save. Rebound swept away. It's almost like he doesn't want to take a forehand. Hallbauer shoots it off the end boards for Linden. Moore trying to knock it away, and now Thrunt.
Well, what you saw there was a textbook two-on-two with Adamo and Linden.
Another chance for one here. Drop pass, shot comes in, save, rebound. Beaton trying to throw it out in front. It was a good play by Adamo. Once he got that puck back, quickly got it over to John Beaton. He looked for the wraparound, but he wasn't quite able to pull it off. Coronado getting roughed up by Beaton. Ends up knocking him down, but the puck's underneath Coronado. Now he gets it back. Matthew Coronado spins around the point. Nice move there to get free to the slot. He gets chopped down by Adamo.
See, that doesn't make any sense.
Could have been a penalty there.
Yeah.
It's like a trip, for
based
sure.
Based on what they've been calling?
Right.
Well,
both teams are back out, or both teams are back to even. Back to full strength, I guess. Another hit behind the play. Penalty coming up on Harvard. It's going to be an elbow. And so for the first time tonight, RPI is going to go on the power play.
There it is.
Farinacci is going to get called for it.
Sold it.
I'm not quite sure how high his elbow got there, but
yeah.
Johnson.
Harvard penalty to number 17, John Farinacci.
Because his head
he
snapped back.
2 minutes for elbowing. Time of that
first power play for RPI here comes
seconds.
With 10:23 to go in the second period, down 5-0. Here's Walsh, a shot looking for the redirection. Laka trying to tip it home, but it's glove somehow by Mullahy.
Wow, what a save there. Laka had the whole open net, but you know what? I thought it was too casual with it.
A little bit. I also thought he missed by the way he reacted because it didn't go in, but then I realized it was in Mullahy's glove. Ridiculous. Yeah, you want to be calm around the net front, but not that calm.
Oh, you see that open net, you want to shoot it like you're going to put it through the back of the net. That way an errant stick or something doesn't come out and prevent you from putting it in.
Ninth RPI shot there for Laka. Linden dangling his way in. Gave it across to Lapinen, who just couldn't find the handle until he was below the goal line. Then he'll shoot it around where it leaves the zone. RPI's power play this year up to 17.4% after their two goals yesterday. That's a pretty good number.
Definitely.
Linden drops it back. Lapinen back to Linden. Send it across. One-timer Laka. And just getting his stick in there was Jack Donato to make a play. Slapped around by Laka for Linden. First 30-point score for RPI since Riley Bourbonnais as a shot tips wide from Laka on a slap shot from Baxter. Back in 2016-17 was Riley Bourbonnais's big season. He made big strides at Riley throughout his 4 years. Not too dissimilar from how Tour has improved.
Yes, I remember that. Riley was a good player.
He came in, I think he only played a handful of games his freshman year, Bourbonnais.
Yep.
But by the time he left, he was one of RPI's most talented forwards. That's going to get out of play. I think he made it up. He was playing in the East Coast for a little while, Riley. I can't remember if he ever got to the Penguins AHL team or not. Scranton or Wilkes-Barre. But he definitely started off with the Nailers for a few years, I'm pretty sure.
Wheeling
Nailers, yes. Here we go. Baxter trying to feed it across there for Dubinsky. And it was intercepted, now short-handed. Does enough here to just at least waste some time. He'll take a hit from Adamo, and he'll do it for the RPI power play. Engineers 0-for-1.
Harvard returns to full strength.
Out of the box, Farinacci trying to break up the rush, but Mashey keeps on trucking. Nice job by Chelberg at the line. A shot and a glove save by Mullahy. As he saw that one pretty well.
We'd like to welcome RPI
Simon looking for goal number 6.
Rensselaer students, student athletes, faculty.
Need a little more traffic as he'll beat him from there.
Yeah, that's a
thank
good
you
shot,
for your
though.
Support of
trying
RPI
to go against the grain.
Enjoy the game. Let's go
right to left. It shoots it back to the glove side of.
Your support of Let's Go Red ensures
got any
that
scores for us,
future
coach?
Generations
sure.
of
pull them up while we check out the stats so far.
Well, you know what? They would have just got going because we started at 6.
Oh, that's right. I'm not sure what I'm asking. Everyone probably 0-0.
Help RPI
that's why I didn't look earlier. Can I take it
RPI.edu/Let's Go Red.
Let's see. Well, Cornell's up 1-0 after the first minute of the play in the first period. Cornell's up 1-0 on Princeton. And zeros for the rest.
And there's got to be some women's hockey finals from the playoffs.
There are.
There are some wild games.
Yep. Well, Colgate advances because they beat Cornell.
Okay.
3-2? Yes.
Yep.
And then I don't have anything for Princeton, Harvard.
And
Quinnipiac moves
those
on.
Those games should be over.
Yeah. Quinnipiac moves on because they beat
Clarkson 4-0. Yeah.
So let me go to my ECAC hockey app.
All right. Look at you. You're selling the brand right here.
Yes. And then go to women's hockey. And Harvard beat Princeton 2-1.
In overtime.
That series is tied at 1, so there's a game tomorrow.
Yep. And then Yale beat St. Lawrence. So that's tied, right?
Yep.
So you have two game threes tomorrow on the women's side.
Yale and St. Lawrence, Princeton.
At Harvard. That's the number one seed, right?
Yes.
Harvard. As this puck trickles in on Lyndon Marshall, he'll cover up. 8:02 to go second period. It's 5-0 Harvard here. The Crimson have one goal here in this frame. So yesterday, Princeton became the second ever 8 seed to win a playoff game on the women's side. And the only other team was backstopped by Lavisa Solander when the RPI engineers beat Cornell a few years ago. Only 2 8 seeds have ever won a game in the women's tournament. And that's going to change as ECAC hockey continues on the women's side to be so balanced and so talented. As the shot's going to be stopped by Marshall. They're jamming it at the side of the net. It'll go behind to the corner.
Wow.
Knocked in the air to center ice, and Seller, Shane Seller, former Dartmouth Big Green, hands it off there to Rory Herman. Kept in at the blue line nicely. Herman's got some time behind the goal. He gets roughed up there by Kyle Acoin. And now 3-on-2. Farinacci sending it back, and oh boy, what a stop by Marshall.
Whoa, that was a great save by Marshall.
Goodness.
That was LaFerriere that had that shot, but following up was Farinacci.
You got to be kidding me.
Farinacci was going at it with Gagnon.
Look at this. Look at this glove stop. Oh!
What a save. What I was going to say is Farinacci was going at it in front of the net with Gagnon. Then Farinacci took off. That was Gagnon's guy on the back check. That's why it turned into a 3-on-2. But Marshall bails him out.
Big time save there by Lyndon Marshall. Probably his best save of the year. RJ Murphy, senior from Needham. Spinning around in the corner. No points this year in 21 games for Murphy. Austin Wong. Back to the point. Jimenez's shot gets knocked down by traffic. And Moore back at center, gave it away. Shot off the end boards. Adamo at the half wall. Sends it back. Wrist shot, blocker's save by Mulahy. Right back down low. Good cycle work here from this RPI unit here. Adamo leaves it in the corner. Intentional or not, it worked out for RPI. Lapping in off the bench. Finds some room, takes a shot. Got a deflection. Adamo was standing in front. Crimson finally able to capture the puck here, and then losing an edge and going down was Wong. And this will be on goal, so no icing here against RPI. And the Crimson do ice it. 5:40 left in the second. Go ahead, Coach.
Well, I was just going to say that's because they missed Donato on the half wall. Pass was out of his reach. So it goes down the length of the ice.
Yeah. Shot off the faceoff from Linden was blocked right away. Hallbauer back to neutral ice with it in his own zone. Now Lockup. A couple assists last night for Jacob. He's up over 20 points this year.
Tell you what, Lepinen, you're right. Lepinen's been real impressive in the faceoff dot last night and tonight.
Yeah, he's his season numbers. He only started taking draws recently. They still list Linden as the center, which I guess doesn't really matter. And from a matchup standpoint, you're not really showing your hand there. Of course, teams look at film, but yeah, he's done a pretty good job so far.
Nice to know you have two guys out there that are capable.
Nadal-Vile, 29 wins on the season, 18 losses. That's a 62% faceoff winning percentage. They'll get the job done for sure as Davies takes his shot. But again, just not a lot of traffic, and Malahi was able to see that all the way. You know, it's one funny thing about this year, Coach, is I don't think we're, barring an outstanding comeback here for RPI, is I don't think we're going to see a shootout all year.
They instituted the shootout rule
this year in ECAC hockey, and RPI has not played in one. Guess we'll have to wait till next year. As obviously in the playoffs, they play the different overtime rules, the ones that we're accustomed to, the continuous OT, which makes for some of the longest games of the season at times. Nice move by Bowman. Still on the puck, Nick Bowman. Gets it back to the point. Agnew, a wrist shot, hit a boot. Abrazisi was flying by. Dubinsky. Back for Bowman. Engineers have put together some good shifts here in the second period. Have not been able to turn it into a goal yet, but the chances are coming. Under four to go in the second. Good outlet pass here. Crimson skated ahead. Wrist shot blocked into the corner. That was Coronado. Schellberg. He gets knocked down. Baxter. Gloved down at the blue line, but forced out to center by Herman. What are you looking to see from the engineers over these final 20 minutes and change now?
I think they picked up their game here as far as their passing and applying some offensive pressure. Doing a little bit of better job in the forecheck, not spending as much time in their own end.
Herman trying to make a move, lost it. Turned around by Kyle Acoin. And we got an icing call.
Might be time to leave a guy in the neutral zone for that long stretch pass.
Now, Acoin, the son of Adrian Acoin, longtime NHLer.
Yep.
It's cool to see all these. RPI has a handful of their own. You know, sons of former NHL players getting a chance to play college hockey. It's great to see them also in college hockey, right?
Yes.
Taking that route. And you hope more talented young hockey players take that route. You get the education and you get the chance to play a lot of games, and it's not quite the hockey workload you might see in juniors, but I think it's a good route to go.
Yes, definitely.
With the living accommodations that colleges have and everything that goes with it, the support is there at the college level that they might not find other places. I'm sure it is to a certain degree, but I think I'm biased, of course.
You know, I just think that you have to have a lot of patience if you're a young, real good young hockey player, because OHL, the major juniors, are trying to grab you right then.
Right.
And then with most programs these days, you have to wait until you're 20, 21 years old before you're off to college.
Right, so there is a patience to it, but I think it does pay off in the end, and you see a lot of
definitely.
You know, even if it's for a year or two, when it's the Jack Eichel, the 1 year at BU, or I think Ryan Donato might have played 3 years. at Harvard.
Well, believe it or not, there are some NHL teams that prefer going OHL, and there are NHL teams that don't care, and some like the development process in college.
I mean, the Pittsburgh Penguins have made, have had a lot of success with college players.
Definitely,
shot and a save, and so when we saw, you know, Will Riley go to Pittsburgh, and then he's still in their AHL affiliate right now, but, you know, being drafted by one of those teams that likes the college game and respects it, has to be good for the player to know that they're in good hands.
Yes, yeah.
And you'll get the full opportunity to have a chance to make it to the highest level. 2 minutes to go here in the second, 5-0, Harvard on top.
It all has to do with the market value as a player.
And with COVID, more and more guys are getting chances this year. A lot of times, that's all you need is an opportunity to show what you're able to do. We're hoping Will gets that chance at some point, like others before him have. Here's Linden into the zone, off for Laka, Rister high and wide. Poked out to center. Lepinen has to be careful there because the puck's long gone. Donato.
Tell you what.
Yeah.
Lepinen's a tough kid. He went down hard in that corner, and I was just waiting for him to make his way to the bench, but he stayed
this
out there.
This is the final minute of play in the period. Last minute of play, and it's the most minute of the game.
It's your last regular season home game, Coach.
Your engineer scoring this final minute. Fans receive a free taco at Moe's at RPI in Troy. The most
race with the puck.
Agnew's
going to get there. Final minute of the second period here. Coronado chips it off the wall to himself. Actually, now it's Abbruzzese. The run, trying to make a move. It was poked away by Mashey. And shot back in. And we got a whistle here.
Offside.
Delayed offside.
What's interesting is that if they score, you get free nachos at Moe's.
Free taco.
Taco.
I think it's a free taco, singular.
Yet, if you look at the back of the ticket that the students get, you get a free appetizer on the day of the game over at the recovery room.
That's a kind of a two-for-one.
Exactly.
I see you looking for deals.
I go looking for tickets.
Yeah, I see that. Mashey trying to walk his way in, and he couldn't steer it towards the net. To the line and out of the zone, and that do it for the second period. Well, no tacos for the kids, but you can get what? Something off the apps.
Yeah, I was But Wong tried to pass that puck to himself by throwing it up in the air and then skating to it. But he got sat on. Yeah.
Meet Coach for apps after the game. That's all I can tell you. We're gonna take a break and be back with the third period. It's 5-0 Harvard
saves
after
in the
two.
Second period.
You're watching RPI
Harvard
Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.
9 saves, a 2-period total of 13. And for Lyndon Marshall of RPI, 8 saves. For Marshall, 2-period total of 16 saves. Hey, if you're looking to take the cruise or all-inclusive vacation of a lifetime, Yankee Trails is the Capital Region's premier travel agency and motor coach tour provider. They specialize in group travel, and Yankee Trails is also available for all your group transportation needs. For more information, call 518-286-2400 or visit online at yankeetrails.com. The RPI Pep Band. Ben and Jerry's is located in the Student Union, so don't forget, stop by and grab your favorite flavor. From cow to cone, enjoy your scoop. Ben and Jerry's, proud to support RPI hockey.
Third period about to get underway from the Houston Fieldhouse. Final regular season game. RPI and Harvard. Crimson looking to even the season series and appear to be on their way, but there's still a lot of time left here. And you know, anything can happen, Coach.
Anything can happen. You got that right. One shot at a time, chip away. Which might...
Malahi, he's been pretty good, but engineers haven't really tested him too much. So if they can maybe feel a little pressure. 13 shots so far for the engineers. You get a goal or two.
Well, even though Marshall's let in five, he does still have the save of the game.
That's true. Can't take that away from him. Save of the year candidates, maybe. Farinacci, pass was blocked. Johnson is tied up, but Kyle Hallbauer is going to skate away with it. Hallbauer dumps it in. Moore. Thrun. Henry Thrun chipping up the board. It's kept in for a second there by Gagneau. Big swing and a miss by Chober. Battles back to win it back momentarily. It's back to center ice for Seedham. Coronado sends it back to the blue line. A lot of heat on that pass. Rafai could just barely keep it in the zone. Now Dubinsky for the engineers. Zach Dubinsky on the move. This cross ice pass was blocked back to RPI territory. Baxter there.
Yeah, he waited just a little too long to get that pass to the trailer.
Marshall Rafai, senior from Beaconsfield, Quebec. Crimson shoot it in. Marshall stops it there. Linden with the 16 saves so far. Crimson are offside, but the engineers have the puck anyway. Adamo, Seller, gives it back. Rebound pops out.
That just went over the stick of beat.
Seller took the shot, and then Adamo kind of redirected it there. Bounced right by Beaton, as Coach mentioned. That'll be dumped in by Adamo. John Fusco battling for it there. His uncle and his father both played for Harvard back in your day.
Yep, played against those guys. Good hockey players.
Murphy. Shot comes in. From Jimenez, looking for his first career goal there. The save was made by Marshall.
Looks like he was going top shelf as well.
Walsh. Herman. Walsh shoots it off the end boards. Crimson trying to move it out of the zone. Ian Moore. Kjellberg now. Rory Herman, junior from Poway, California, shoots this one out of play. 16:28 to go in the third. Harvard up 5-0 here. Got 11 graduating student athletes here for RPI. I'm sure they all want to score on their senior night here, but so far nothing doing. Oh, it was a hit along the wall. Can't see who the engineer was, but they're back up on their feet, thankfully. Baxter chips it up for Lepinen. Back to Baxter. Backhander in front, looking for Linden, but Malahi did a good job to stick that stick out and break it up. Cross ice, pass good, fine lockup. Drops it off, Lepinen. One-timer, they score! Tour Linden with his third goal of the weekend, and RPI does get on the board here.
Well, he hammered that one on a great feed from who else? I mean, he just set that on the table. You can't get that any nicer.
Malahi did get a piece of it, but yep. Not enough. Clearly, goal number 17 for Tour Linden. 32 points now in the season for the senior from Great Falls, Virginia.
RPI goal was scored by number 19, Tour Linden.
And icing here against the
he
Crimson.
He was assisted by number 11, Arovile Lepinen. And by number 39, Jacob Laka. Time of that goal, 4 minutes and 8 seconds. RPI goal by 19, Linden, his 17th of the season, from 11, Lepinen, and 39, Laka at 4:08.
Johnson up the wall.
We need another quick one here.
Coach is getting greedy already. He saw one. Wants another. Mashey fired that one. He gets it back. Trying to shoot it through a couple of players there. Thrun. Karpa. Great start to this game. Haven't seen a lot from Karpa. He does have 3 points in this game, but maybe it's just natural, but maybe, you know, see, it feels a little bit like the Crimson have taken their foot off the pedal as the second period went on, but obviously credit the engineers with ramping things up as well. Agnew. Johnson for Adamo. He lost it. Coronado trying to pick his pocket, but Adamo gets back on it. Trying to force it out to center. Adamo goes down. Baker short. Marshall's just going to let it ride. It actually pops back out in front of the net, but Agnew is going to sweep ahead. Short. Adamo throws a hit. Puck in deep, and Jack Agnew will pick it up again. Sophomore from Oakville, Ontario, former BC Eagle. Ahead for Adamo. Poking it on for Seller. Seller finds it. Takes a shot from a tight angle. Save, and the puck comes loose. As Beaton was in good position, but he just couldn't find it. Casey Dornbach drops it back. Jimenez, a long shot gloved at by Marshall, but didn't hold. Tipped into the corner. Dornbach again. Griffey. Nice pass down low. Saved by Marshall. Read that play well. As Dornbach was loose on the near post, but Marshall read it and covered up the whole net there for him.
Yeah, Harvard likes to make that pass off the net with a one-time shooter sitting there.
Davies lost it. Gave it away. Murphy. R.J. Murphy around the net. Sends it down low. Wong. Back to Murphy. Murphy trying to jam it in, but a good poke check by Marshall. Laka. Looking for Linden, but it's poked away. Now Linden gives it back to Laka. Laka looking for Lepinen, and he threw it through a skate. Somehow found Lepinen. Didn't think there was a lot of room to make that pass. We got a puck. Maybe hit somebody in the bench. 12:53 to play here in the third. RPI on the board. Tour Linden picking up his team-leading 17th goal of the season.
Yeah, Lepinen just about connected again.
I was thinking Laka was going to shoot that from where he was. Now Walsh, a shot and a save from close range. Chances have been just about all engineers here in this third period. Good hit by Chelberg. And he'll pick the puck out of some skates and work it to center ice for Herman. Rory Herman dumping in. Fusco wrapping it around to the near side. Laferriere. Ahead for Farinacci. He has it on the half wall. Seedum joining the play. His shot was tipped by Laferriere. Now he gets dumped in the corner. Nick Bowman will pick it up. And he'll elect to just dump in here. Malahi has it aside. Outlet pass was broken up. RPI will turn it around. And Gagneau couldn't reach that one. It'll be icing on RPI.
RPI Athletics, working with local schools in Troy as part of the Shoot for the Stars program.
Well, the reason why RPI I said they needed a quick one is because if you get one every 5 minutes, it's only going to be four.
RPI Hockey, our local youth and local communities.
That is true. The time between goals you need is shrinking. And another icing call. RPI fans thought that Ian Moore could have maybe played that puck. That one wired off the glass from Coronado, who has a goal tonight. His 13th of the year. Sent back to the blue line. Thrun. He fires one that hits the shin pad of Dubinsky. You know, RPI has numbers if they hurry here. Well, the pass is behind Dubinsky. Coronado sends it through the middle. That's intercepted. Gagneau just gave it right away to Coronado. Abruzzese trying to make a move. Pass back to the point. Thrun. Blocked by Gagneau. And now Beaton. Beaton trying to make a move on a forward, takes a shot on the left pad, save. It's actually Seedham, excuse me, who's back there defending.
Yeah, I like the thought process there, moving from your right to left and throwing it back towards the goaltender's left-hand side.
Going against the grain there now. Dornbach waiting, shooting, that's blocked. And a shot from no angle by Donato is stopped as well by Marshall.
Yeah, I think he was trying the old bank play off the goaltender, but Marshall got squared up pretty quick.
Yeah, Marshall moves pretty well laterally. That's, I think, one of his strengths as a goalie. And he's seen enough pucks. He can read a play as it's developing. And he's almost kind of learned throughout this one what the big, what the Crimson are trying to do. And he's gotten in good position. Beaton looking for Adamo, carried on by Seller. Shane Seller driving wide all the way around the net, hands it off to Davies, pinching down. Now Linden, Shore couldn't clear, kept in, played around behind by a coin, and now high off the glass back into RPI territory where Agnew waits for it, has to deal with Murphy. Linden doing his job as a center, helping out in the middle of the ice and covering the defensive end. Seedham. Back for Jimenez. Christian Jimenez, just his fifth game of the year, as that shot comes in. Easy stop there on the try by Seedham.
RPI,
27 shots in the game for the Crimson to 18 for RPI. As we have RPI our mid-period break, 9:39 to go, third period. Engineers have the only goal of this frame. Tour Linden picking up his team-leading 17th of the year. Real nice passing play from one of his buddies, RPI's top line. And when you get to the playoff, you know, playoff time, Coach, and next weekend, you're going to rely on those guys, the three L's, the Leppinen, Linden, and Laka group, to kind of carry the team offensively and score the big goals.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's pretty obvious. They've got real good chemistry. I mean, the only guy that I've seen that they've replaced throughout the course of the season was the right winger. You know, now it's Laka that's playing on that side. At times, you saw Walsh there. But for the most part, Linden and Leppinen have been playing together. They've got real, real good chemistry together. And that's what you look. That's what you look for as far as offense is concerned.
You obviously need some secondary scoring, and you'd like to see it from, you know, the Mashy and Dubinsky and sometimes the Damo group, or the Walsh meet the Damo, whoever that ends up playing there.
Yeah, well, that's going to be the key.
There are options, right?
Yeah, there are. But that's going to be the key, because, you know, there are some coaches that like to match lines, and there's some coaches that don't match lines. If you're on the road for that second round, and you're trying to match lines, you're not going to have that advantage.
Seedham centering, and the shot from Lyons is blocked. Laka picks it up. He'll shoot it ahead. Linden trying to beat out the icing, and he will. He's wrapped up in the corner. Lapping it over there with him. Comes free to Tour. Back to the point. Shelberg, wrist shot off the end boards. Karam's back. It's swept back into the corner. Now back to Shelberg. Shelberg down low. Redirected wide as Linden was there. Now thrown in front, and it's gloved by Mullahy.
Yeah, a lot of good battles going on out there. Laka especially. He was battling, trying to create some space for himself, pushing the Harvard player, and they were going at it. I think he was a little late on getting to that puck, but nice place, throwing it to the net. Mullahy's right there for it.
Clean win by Dubinsky. Nice move by Baxter to get free. Anthony Baxter around the net. Takes a shot up high, save by Mullahy. To the point, a shot, another stop by Mullahy. Rebound free to Mashey. Dubinsky just got dumped in the crease. He's still floating it up. He's going to draw a penalty.
Yeah. That's going to be Moore going to the box for interference.
Mullahy lost his mask, or maybe just took it off just now. I think there's a penalty coming up.
There is.
Okay.
Yep. Moore for interference. That's the one that dropped Dubinsky.
Okay.
2 points for a takedown.
Yeah. So RPI will get its second power play. They're 0-1. Harvard is 2-3 on
Harvard
the power.
Harvard penalty to number 2, Ian Moore. He receives 2 minutes for interference. Time in that penalty, 11 minutes, 14 seconds.
Coach Smith has a question
Moore.
For the official. Probably
2 minutes for interference.
Stop guys on rest.
It's an East Stewart Jones, Hacker Murphy power play for the Engineers.
Well, he's getting the break here that he wants. RPI's power play, a couple of goals yesterday and four chances, and now just their second chance today. But
they're
going to look at some. Maybe you're looking at it for more. They could be looking at it for a major. That's all they can do here, Coach.
Yeah, I don't know that was a major.
I mean, they're going to look at it.
To be honest with you, I think the takedown on Lepinen in the far corner was probably more of a penalty.
Okay, but by rule, again, we saw this play out earlier this year.
Yep.
Anytime they look at something for a penalty, it has to be it's called on ice, which is either what they call the two-minute interference, or nothing. That if there was no penalty call, it has to be nothing or a five-minute major. They can't go and put 2 minutes on the. They can't go and look back and call a two-minute penalty.
Okay, so is that a request that's made by the coach? Or can the referees say?
The referees can decide. They can say, I want another look at that. And then they can go look.
Gotcha.
I think the coach can request anything, right?
Right.
It's not an official challenge as it would be for a goal review, whether it be offside or puck didn't go in.
But the official can say,
I'll look at it again.
I don't think there's a major there. Let's continue.
Yes.
Maybe he's looking for a face mask. That's maybe why it came off.
Sorry, I just ran down for clarification.
Yeah, that's okay. The only thing I could think of is that he thought maybe it was a face mask.
Okay.
Because you had mentioned a face mask had come off, but
yeah.
No, it's a two-minute minor.
All right, so, yeah, they were looking to see if there was more to the interference penalty that could have warranted a major, but no. So RPI second power play starts here. Johnson off for Linden. Tuert. Laka, Linden. Back up top for Johnson, a wrist shot, glove save, rebound loose, picked up by Lepinen. Johnson, wrister, that one takes a deflection wide. Linden, behind the goal for Laka. Centering pass, Linden, a shot and a save. Mulahy again, this is shot into the penalty box, so the faceoff will remain in Harvard territory. 1:19 to go on the power play. Engineers looking real good, though.
Yeah, they are.
On this power play.
Linden was, again, wide open back door.
Yeah. Similar tough to what he scored on.
Yeah, tough. He had to stop that because that would have been a tough pass for one time. Harvard couldn't change on that because they shot the puck out of the rink.
Bit of a break there for the Engineers. Now a face-off win for the Crimson, and they clear it down. RPI doing the job.
And they get a wholesale change.
Under eight to go here in the third. It's 5-1 Harvard. Kjellberg for Dubinsky, who shoots it in. Adamo is... Mulahy fell down trying to get back to the net. RPI couldn't quite track it down, so it doesn't matter. Baxter. Dubinsky. It's knocked down there by Seedham. And now Baxter again. Hands it off for Mashey. Snaps it over to Kjellberg. Kjellberg, a shot. Hit the leg of Seedham. Puck goes behind the goal. Mashey there with Adamo. Mashey, circle, shot. That's blocked. And Thrun shoots it out of play again.
I think that went off Baxter.
Oh, might have. You're right. Faceoff going to come outside the zone. Faceoffs are 35-22 Harvard. Engineers shoot this one in off that draw. RPI to the point. Two to go in the power play. Johnson off for Lepinen.
Harvard returns.
Penalty over. RPI still attacking. Johnson. Linden up top. Johnson a drive, and it's hammered wide. And that shot out of play again. 6:32 left, yeah.
I think that puck was rolling.
A little bit. Yeah, Mulahy, he's made some glove saves. He hasn't held a lot. Seems like he's made some stops and things are just kind of bouncing off of him. Which you're up by 5-1, it isn't really a problem. And of course, Mitchell Gibson will probably go tomorrow. Played yesterday.
Yep.
But some good experience for the sophomore. Bowman. Sends it over to Davies, who has a couple assists on the year, but no goals yet. The sophomore D-man playing in his first collegiate season. Herman lifting it into the Crimson end. Jimenez shoots it around. Abrazizi doesn't know how the corner boards operate here at the Houston Fieldhouse, and that thing's not going to roll cleanly along the wall sometimes.
Players, when you're sitting on the bench, make sure you're paying attention because that happened in the first period, and they should know better by now.
Well, it happens a lot here. If you, although I don't know if they had morning skate, but if you ring a puck around near the Zamboni door or that the Pepsi or the RPI TV logo in the east zone of the rink, you're gonna find that puck doesn't go where you think it's gonna go.
To be honest with you, I'm surprised RPI doesn't ring it into that corner more often.
Yeah, you're right, because they're the ones who could see it every day. Seedham. Nice find there, Abrazisi. Knocked out of the air by Hullbauer, who just dumps it right back in. Seedham again. Good poke there. Hullbauer. It's cleared out. Race for the puck. Ferrier has it poked away by Louis Helson. Seller runs into Fusco but gets it into the zone. Approaching 5 minutes to go in the third. Shot in from center ice. Harvard not trying to do much more than just gain the red line and dump in right now.
They've taken their foot off the gas offensively.
Chipped along here. Kjellberg was half in the Harvard bench. Now we've got a chance to break the other way. And as it knocked away by Rafai. High off the glass and didn't go very far. Now Baxter picks it up and the engineers are onside. Gagne, a shot save. Dubinsky a try, and that one's kicked away as well. Two quick shots for the engineers, and Malahi keeps them both out. Dubinsky again in the slot, trying to jam it home. Gagne! Almost had a similar chance to his first career goal yesterday on a redirection, but he couldn't steer it through the legs. Baxter fires wide. Kjellberg making a move at the wall for Gagne. That doesn't connect. Stripped away and cleared out of play by Lyons.
Call that face-off inside.
Yeah. RPI has closed the shots on goal gap. 27-24 is the Harvard advantage now, but as we talked about, the Crimson aren't looking to shoot the puck really anymore. They're thinking about post-game meal maybe. Linden. Lapping it. Gets away from Farinacci, but not more. Tour Linden. Back to the point, and Agnew had vacated. Something about that blue line over there, that guy's get stuck to it. I don't know what it is. Nice pass inside for Laka. Rister flutters wide.
I don't think it's a Velcro
blue line. Yeah.
Have Velcro on their pants.
Yeah. I'm starting to think it is, though. Because every time somebody goes over there, they get stuck to the wall. Ferrier to center ice, bouncing puck Agnew. Hand it off for Hullbauer. Beaton spinning around, looking for the puck, and never found it. Laferriere. Hullbauer. And now Karpa. Trying to turn the corner on Hullbauer. He forces him out of the zone. Adamo lost it to Karpa. Karpa takes a hit from Agnew. Adamo around, pinching in is Seedham. Abrazisi back to the line. He'll throw it in. Karpa. Coronado looking for the top corner. Kept in nicely at the line by Thrun. Oh, nice move. Abrazisi down low for Coronado. And he just couldn't steer it home. Would have been a tap in if he could have got a stick on it.
He's got some shake and bake there. That's quick movement.
Karpa in the middle. Seller, a chance to clear maybe. And he gets it out to center ice with some help from Beaton. Right. 2 minutes to go in the third.
Spent a lot of time in the zone. They're going to be looking to change like they did.
Herman knocks Coronado over. Now Walsh trying to tiptoe his way up ice. He'll gain some speed into the slot. Walsh is shot right on. What an individual effort there by TJ Walsh to create a chance all on his own.
That was a great move. Kind of a stutter step.
Yeah, I mean, a nice move at his own blue line, then a nice move at the Harvard blue line, and found himself between the dots. But again, Malahi, I talked about his rebound control, maybe needing a little bit of work, but other than that, he's been a real good shot stopper tonight.
Yeah, he has. I mean, to get the opportunity and for Coach Donato to put him in a situation where, as we've mentioned, it's really not going to affect where each of these teams finish the regular season.
Yeah. It's almost the perfect spot for a sophomore like himself to find this opportunity.
Well, hey, he's going to give the coach some confidence here to play him whenever he's going to be needed.
Plus, it's 3-3. We talked about that as well. You don't want your goalie playing three games in a row if it's not a playoff situation, that being Mitchell Gibson, your starter. Mashey goes for an adventure here in his own end with a little bit of pressure. Now Gagneau, 56 to go in the game. Baxter, stick handling. Trying to walk his way in. As we've reached the showtime stage of the third period. 36 to go. High in the air to center. And I don't know if on it for icing. Hallbauer takes a look. Louis Helsin. Linden, one more shift here for RPI's top line. Into the zone, nice catch by Wong. He gets tied up and doesn't get his shot away. Good play by Louis there. And that's how this one will end. As RPI falls here to Harvard 5-1. We talked about, you know, maybe just trying to win the third period. And that's what RPI was able to do.
Yep, yep.
As they score the only goal of the final frame, Tor Linden picking up the tally there. Henry Thrun, the junior defenseman, picked up two goals for Harvard to lead the way for the
saves
Crimson.
In the third period for Derek Belahi of Harvard, 11, play. A two, three-period total
and
of 24.
To cruise
and
at the end,
for
RPI,
Linden Marshall of RPI, 6
we
in the third
like
period
saw,
and
though,
a two-period total.
Especially end of the third period.
A three-period
third
total of 22 saves.
We saw more of what
for
we saw
Marshall.
Yesterday, what we saw
final
for
score, Harvard 5. RPI
kind of right
one, and once again,
look like it'd be a tough sledding to try and come back. And
we invite you to remain in your seats for the senior recognition ceremony coming up in just a few minutes.
Pack your bags right there, but
tonight's gatherers, granola player of the game from Harvard, number 59, Zachary Karpa.
Good looks and some good opportunities. So they'll just sit back and scoreboard watch to see who they may end up with come next weekend.
RPI will be home next weekend for the opening round of the ECAC hockey tournament. Harvard has a bye, so they'll wait another weekend here. As the final regular season stick salute is underway here for the RPI engineers, who dropped to 15-20-3 on the year. They finished the season at 10-12-0 in ECAC hockey play. Harvard picks up its 16th win. They're 16-9-3 on the year. They close out ECAC hockey play at 13-6-3. We're going to hand it over to Al Shibley, PA, for the senior announcements here. Coach and I will get out of here, but we want to thank you for a season long of watching RPI hockey, Coach, and it's been a fun year calling games with you.
Yeah, I agree. It's been a lot of fun, and look forward to next weekend for the playoffs.
Playoffs coming up here.
Once again, good evening, everyone, and
RPI
thank
TV
you
crew
for joining us for this evening
coach,
as we honor the graduating seniors.
Once again, thank you for watching RPI hockey tonight. Final score, Harvard 5,
before recognizing
RPI 1. This
the players,
we'd
first like to recognize and
TV
thank
and
the senior members of the RPI Pep Band and RPI TV. From the RPI Pep Band, seniors Lucretia Schumati, Jonathan Goodman, Reno Malanga, Alex Rishti, Colin McMaster, Joe Papini, Brandon Bolzani, Michaela Gray, Josiah Time, Garrett Paquette, Brian Smith, Olivia Mariani, Justin Hubbard, Cooper Wataja, and Will Z. From the RPI Pep Band. And the seniors representing RPI TV, Eric Roberts, Eric Svetlishny, Joe Dectano, Deepti Sachi, Anu Chandracheska. The seniors from RPI TV. We want to thank you for your dedication to Rensselaer. Best of luck in all your future endeavors. And now, to acknowledge the accomplishments of the 11 members of the Rensselaer Men's Hockey Class of 2022, we thank them for their dedication, their commitment to RPI Men's Hockey. We'll now take a moment to honor each of them individually. First up is a forward from Oyer, France, number 22, Justin Adamo. Justin joined RPI during the 2021-22 season after spending 3 years at Robert Morris, where he totaled 49 points in 96 games. Justin has amassed 14 points from 10 goals and 4 assists in 34 games at RPI. He's currently second on the team in goals scored. His first goal with RPI was a game-winning tally that came on November 6th against Clarkson. Justin has an undergraduate degree in finance and is pursuing his master's in supply chain management. Ladies and gentlemen, Justin Adamo. Next is a forward from Bratislava, Slovakia, number 39, assistant captain Jacob Latka. Jacob has compiled 32 points with 11 goals, 21 assists, and 74 career games with the Engineers. He's having his best season this year with 6 goals, 14 assists for 18 points, currently fourth on the team in scoring. A business and management major, Jacob found success in the classroom as well, being named to the ECAC Hockey All-Academic Team in both the 18-19 and 19-20 seasons. Ladies and gentlemen, Jacob Latka. Next is a forward from Great Falls, Virginia, number 19, Captain Tor Linden. A durable player, Tor has played in all 107 games in 3 active seasons, producing 61 points on 25 goals, 36 assists. This season, Tor has reached a career high in goals and points, currently leading the team in scoring. His on-ice success earned him a nomination for the Hobie Baker Award. Academically, Tor graduated magna cum laude with business and management undergraduate degrees and is currently completing his master's in business administration. He was named to the ECAC Hockey All-Academic Team in 18-19 and the 2019-21 seasons, as well as an All-American Scholar in the 2021 season. Joining Tor on the ice are his parents, Pontus and Danielle, and sister, Vicenta. Ladies and gentlemen, Tor Linden. Next is a goalie from Victoria, British Columbia. Number 1, Captain Lyndon Marshall. He's appeared in 75 games, boasts a 2.97 goals against average and 900 save percentage over the course of his career. Linden has been ECAC Rookie of the Week, ECAC Goalie of the Week twice, and has reached his personal season-high wins total with 9 this season. He's completing his master's in supply chain management after earning his bachelor's in mechanical engineering. He has been named to the ECAC Hockey All-Academic Team the last 3 seasons and was an ECAC Hockey Student Athlete of the Year finalist on 2 separate occasions. Ladies and gentlemen, Lyndon Marshall. Next is a defenseman from Oakville, Ontario, number 5, Anthony Baxter. Anthony joined RPI during the 2021-22 season after playing 4 years at University of Massachusetts Lowell, where he amassed 8 goals, 21 assists for 29 points in 116 career games. He's having his most productive season offensively for the Engineers with a career high 11 points and 2 goals, 9 assists in 34 games. He's currently 3rd on the team in scoring by defensemen. Academically, Anthony has a degree in finance and accounting and is currently pursuing a master's in supply chain management. Anthony is joined on the ice by his mom, Linda, dad, Norman, grandmother, Frida. Ladies and gentlemen, Anthony Baxter. Next, a forward from Espoo, Finland, number 11, assistant captain, Autoville Leppinen. Arovile has notched 55 points on 16 goals, 39 assists in 104 career games. This season, Leppinen has a career high in goals with 7 and points with 20. He's currently third on the team in scoring. He earned ECAC Player of the Week honors earlier this season. A business and management major, Arovile earned ECAC Hockey All-Academic honors in both the 18-19 and 19-20 seasons. Please welcome to the ice Arovile's father and brother, Geico and Franz Emil. Arovile Leppinen. Next is a defenseman from Howell, New Jersey, number 28, Kyle Hallbauer. In 95 career games, Kyle has amassed 5 goals, 7 assists for 22 points. He scored his first career goal on November 30th, 2018 at Notre Dame, and also scored the game-winning goal against Long Island University early this year at Houston Fieldhouse. Defensively sound as well, Kyle is currently second on the team in blocked shots. Academically, Kyle has his undergraduate degree in business management and is currently a business administration graduate major. He's been placed on the Dean's Honor List and earned ECAC Hockey All-Academic Honors in 19 and 2020. Joining Kyle on the ice today, his parents, Gabrielle and Timothy, his girlfriend, Lily. Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Hallbauer. Next is a forward from Shelby, Michigan, number 7, Nick Bowman. Nick has amassed 10 points on 3 goals, 7 assists, and 59 career games with the Engineers. He recorded his first collegiate goal against Colgate on February 1st, 2019. He scored his first power play goal on February 15th, 2019 against Princeton. A business and management major, Nick earned ECAC Hockey All-Academic Honors in both the 18-19 and 2019-2020 seasons. He was placed on the Dean's Honor List. Please welcome to the ice Nick's mother, Karen, and his girlfriend, Lexi. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nick Bowman. Next is a defenseman from Dallas, Texas, number 21, Louis Helson. Louis has appeared in 8 games over the course of his career, all coming this season. He currently boasts a plus-minus rating of +4, fourth best on the team. In the classroom, Louis is a business and management major who earned ECAC Hockey All-Academic Honors in 2019-20 and was placed on the Dean's Honor List. So please welcome to the ice Louis' parents, Kathy and Louis, and his wife, Natalie. Ladies and gentlemen, Louis Helson. Next is a defenseman from Bloomington, Minnesota, number 23, Jake Johnson. In his 100 career games with the Engineers, Jake has produced 3 goals, 27 assists for 30 points. He's currently having his best season offensively with 16 points on 2 goals, 14 assists, and defensively leads the team in block shots with 46 and plus-minus rating of +9. Academically, he's a business and management major who's been placed on the ECAC Hockey All-Academic Team every year at RPI and named to an AHCA All-American Scholar twice. Joining Jake on the ice are his parents, Karen and Craig, as well as his brother, Tyler. Ladies and gentlemen, Jake Johnson. Next is a forward from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, number 26, assistant captain Shane Seller. Shane is in his first season at RPI after playing 3 years at Dartmouth College, where he compiled 40 points on 16 goals and 24 assists in 94 games. This season, he has 6 goals, 4 assists for 10 points, and is currently tied for 3rd in goals on the team. Shane is currently completing his master's in business administration after earning his bachelor's in biology. He also completed an internship with Capital Blue Cross in 2019. Please welcome to the ice Shane's parents, Carol and Michael, his sister, Kira, and girlfriend Katie. And ladies and gentlemen, Shane Seller. Let's have one more round of applause for your 2022 senior class of RPI hockey.